Hi there everyone. In this video I thought that I would show you how to make this hat. It's not hard to do. It's pretty simple and I do go row by row with you. It's turned out really well. You can do whichever colors you like. You can do it in one color. It looks better doing it in two colors. I might have changed this to a lighter color in the center. Change my dark and lights around because I think it might have stood out more, this flowery part, if it was in the light. But it works out really well. I like it. And as I say, it's not too hard to do. It's pretty easy. And not too much else there. So yeah, let's get started. I did one fairly similar in just this color. The bottom's a bit different and this doesn't stand out quite as well when it's all in one color. It also looks good, so depending on what you want, you can feel free to do it that way. And that's basically it. I'm happy with the way it's turned out, so I hope that you enjoy making it. So let's get started. This project, we are going to be using a size 3.75mm crochet hook, which is an F, and I am using Aunt Lydia's crochet thread, which is a Fashion 3 size. You can use whichever cotton. I mean, you get the red heart as well, which is great. And I'm just doing it in the light blue and a darker blue. And obviously use the ones that you like. You do want to use the same hook and size thread though. So you're going to start off with a slip knot and you're going to do four chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4 chain. And then you're going to join it together in this first one with a slip stitch. Okay, then you're going to chain 3 for your first double crochet, and then you're going to do another 15 doubles in this circle, in the ring that you had made. So you just need to find it there, and then you're going to do 15, so that you have 16 double crochets all together. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm going to go ahead and do mine and make sure that you have 16 all together. All right, so I've gone all the way around. I've got 16 double crochets and I'm just going to slip stitch into the top of that first chain. Now for this round, we're going to be doing a double crochet, chain one, double crochet, chain one, all the way around. So your first one, you're going to do 4. 1, 2, 3, chain 4, and then you're going to do your double crochet in your first one. Now go into this very first one. So in that very first one, double crochet, chain one, double in the next, chain one. And you're going to do this all the way around. One double, chain one, a double, and chain one. So you're going to go all the way around. And you should end up with 16 of these double crochets, and I'll meet you back. All right, here. So I'm going to do my last one in this last stitch and chain one, and then I'm going to slip stitch into this top of the third one, but I'm going to change my colors because I'm going to go with a light color now. So I'm going to just finish it off with my new color. Finish it off by bringing this new thread through. All right. Now I'm good to go again. Now I'm going to chain one and I'm going to do a single crochet in this chain that I had made. And I'm going to chain 3 and I'm going to do a single crochet. And then I'm going to do a single crochet in this chain that I had made. Okay, and then you're going to chain 3 again. And a single in the chain that you had made, so that you look like this. And we're going to just do that all the way around. Chain 3, 1, 2, 3, and a single in this chain that you had made. So I'm going to go ahead and do that all the way around. Chain 3 and one single in this chain. And then I'll meet you once I've done mine. All right, so when you've come all the way around, you do your last single crochet in that space, and then you're going to do your chain 3, and then you're just going to go into this very first stitch that you had made with a slip stitch. Now be sure that you have your 16 chain spaces just be sure that you do have 16 all the way around. Otherwise, you're not going to end up the way that you should be.
Okay.
So you should be looking like this. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to do chain 3 and an extra one, which so it's really chain 4, which stands for chain 1, and then we're going to do a double crochet in this same space. Okay, and then we're going to do a single crochet in this space over here. All right, so you've done your chain 4, a double crochet in the same place, and then you just did a single crochet in the next space. Now you're going to do a double in this single crochet. You're going to do a chain and a double in the same space. Okay, and then you're going to do a single crochet in the chain space. And you're just going to keep repeating this to the end. So a double in your single crochet, a chain 1, and a double in the same space. And then you do a single crochet in this chain space. And that's what you should be looking like. And once again, you need to have 16 of these. So just be sure when you're done with your row that you do have that amount. So it's a double, chain 1, double in the same single crochet, and then a single crochet in the chain space. So I'm going to go ahead and do mine. Double in the single crochet, chain 1, double in the same space, and single crochet in this chain space. Right, so I'm going to go ahead and do mine. I'm going to go all the way around and I will meet you back here. Right, so once you've gone all the way around, be sure that you got 16 of these little clusters, and then do your last single crochet in that chain space, and you're going to just slip stitch into this chain that you had made over here. All right, so now you should have 16 of these going around. So that's not too difficult. If you don't, undo it, because you might have skipped out on a chain space or something. Somewhere you could have made a mistake. Now you're going to do chain 1 and then a single crochet in this very same spot. Just do a single crochet in that same spot. Then you're going to do chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're going to do a single crochet in the chain 1. So where you had made that chain 1, which is in between those two, you're going to just do a single crochet in there. Okay, and then you're going to do chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you're going to do a single crochet once again in here. So this is what you're doing for this round. So all you're doing, chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's a nice easy round, and a single crochet in between the two doubles where you did that one chain, that's where you do a single, and you should look like this. Okay, so just a single in between those, chain 5, single in between there, chain 5, single in between your two doubles that you had made. So do that and I'll meet you back. So once you've gone all the way around, do your single crochet, chain 5, and then you're going to just do a slip stitch in this beginning chain that you had made. Okay, then you're going to do chain, it's actually chain 4, but it's standing for your double crochet and chain 1. And then you're going to do a double crochet in this same space. Just like that. Okay, then you're going to do a single crochet in this middle, the middle of these chains over here. Single crochet. And then in this one, you're going to do the same thing. One double, one chain, and one double in the same space. This is very similar to what you did on the previous round. Okay, and then you're going to do a single crochet in this middle chain. And then once again, one double, one chain, one double, and these two are in that single crochet. And then you're going to do a single crochet in the middle chain. And you're going to do this all the way around. Right, so that you get this look. So all that it is a one double, one chain, one double in the single crochet, and a single in the middle there. One double, one chain, one double, one single. So I'm going to go ahead and go all the way around and I'll meet you back here. Right, so I've gone around and this is going to be my last single crochet in here, and then I'm going to just slip stitch into this top one. So 1, 2, 3, I'll just slip stitch into that. So I'm going to slip stitch into this top stitch with my new color. I'm changing colors. If you're not changing colors, then you don't have to worry about this part. So I'm just going to slip stitch in there and bring my new color through. Well, it's really the darker blue again that I'm using. All right, then you're going to do chain one and you're going to single crochet in this very same spot. Okay, and then you're going to chain 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is that nice easy run. And then you're going to do a single crochet where you did the two doubles with a chain one in between. Where you did the two doubles with a chain one in between, you're going to do a single crochet and then chain 5 again. So this is exactly the same as that previous round that you had done. Go there and then you find your two doubles with a chain one in between. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then where you did the doubles, you go in there with a single. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. 5 and a single in there. And then I'll meet you at the end of this round. I'm going to go all the way around and I'll meet you back here. All right, so I've gone all the way around. Now this one's ending is slightly different. Now be sure that you still got your 16 going around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 16. So just be sure you still got your 16 going around. This one, the ending is your 16th. Now to end this one, you're going to chain 3 and then you're going to do a double crochet into this very first stitch that you had made. And that ends you off like this. All right. Now what you're going to do is you're going to chain 1 and you're going to single crochet. Right, so you're going to chain 1 and then you're going to do a single crochet right in here. In that same space, just do a single crochet there, and then you're going to do chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then single crochet in the middle of this chain 5. Crochet in the middle of this chain, and this is also an easy round. Chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and single crochet in the middle of this chain. And then chain 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And again, single crochet in the middle of this chain 5. So go all the way around, and when you get to the end here, I'll show you what to do, and we're going to do a slightly different ending as well. So go all the way around, and I'll meet you back now. All right, so I've come all the way around by my last one over here, and we're going to do, instead of doing our 5 chain, we're going to do 3 chain, and then you're going to do a treble in this first one. So wrap your yarn around twice and go into that first stitch. And go through 2, go through 2, and go through 2. Right, then you're going to do chain 1 and 1 single crochet in the same space again. I just go through those 2 stitches. Okay, then we're going to do 9 trebles in this space over here. So wrap around twice and go in here and do 9. That's 1, 2, and that's all in the same space, 3. So I'm going to just do my 9 and I'll meet you back here. So I've got my 9 in, then you're going to chain 1 and you're going to do a single crochet in this stitch, whether you go there or actually in the chain space, it doesn't really matter, and then chain 1. And then 9 in here again. Whoops, and it's trebles. That's 1, 2, 8 and 9, and then you're going to do chain 1 and 1 single in here. Whoops, 1 single in there, 1 chain, and then the same thing, 9 trebles in your next chain space. So this is an easy one. 9 trebles, 1 chain, 1 single in the next chain space, 1 chain, 9 trebles in the next, 1 chain, 1 single, 1 chain. So now it's going to be 9 trebles in here, 1 chain, 1 single in the next, and then 1 chain, and then 9 in here. So go around the whole way, and I'll meet you back here once you've got those in. Alright, so I've gone all the way around, and you should have 8 of these going all the way around. So just be sure to have 8 of these. Then you did your last one, and you should be looking like this. You're going to chain 1, and then you're just going to do a single crochet in this beginning over here. a slip stitch. Okay, so you're just going to do a slip stitch over there, and you should be looking like this. All right, so you did your slip stitch in there, and then you chain one. Now you're going to be doing, you chain three, 1, 2, 3, which is standing for your first double crochet. Then you're going to do a double in the next one, a double in the next one, and then you're going to chain two. You're going to skip one and do a single in the next. You're going to chain two, and then you're going to skip one, and you're going to do a double in the next, a double in the next, and a double in the next. All right, so you like this. Double, 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 chain two, skip one, single, chain two, skip one, three doubles. Then you're going to do chain two, and then you're going to start again. You're going to do a double in the first one, and I just started in that very first one there. A double in the next, a double in the next, chain two, skip one, single in the next, chain two, skip one, and a double in the next, a double in the next, and a double in the next. And then you're going to chain two again. And this is what you're just going to keep repeating. So it's a double, chain two, skip one, single in the next, chain two, skip one, and then a double, and a double. And then you'll chain two again. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Go all the way around, and I'll meet you back at the beginning again. All right, so I've come to the end. You do your chain two, and you're going to single crochet, slip stitch into the top of this chain three that you had made. Just slip stitch in there. Okay, now you're going to do chain three, and we're going to do the exact same thing as we did on this previous round. So that was number one. This is number two, so I'm trying to get both strands there. That's number two, number three, and then you do your chain two, and then you're going to single crochet in this single crochet here, chain two, and your three doubles, 1, 2, 3, and then your chain two, that's three, and then chain two, and exactly the same thing, one double in each, 1, 2, 3, your chain two, single in the single, chain two, and one in there, one each in there. So you're going to do one in each of the double crochets, chain two, and a single above the single, chain two in between. So it's exactly the same row as you did before. So I'm going to go ahead and do mine, and I'll meet you back there. All right, so you've got to the end again. Do your chain two, and we're going to just slip stitch into the top of this chain three again. Slip stitch in there, and then chain three. All right, so for this round, we're going to do same thing. Do your three doubles, one in each. Then you're going to do chain two. Now you're going to do a single crochet in this chain space, chain four, 1, 2, 3, 4, and a single in here, chain two, and then your threes over here, one in the first, 1, 2, 3, and then chain two, and then you start it again, one double in here, one double in the next, double in the next, chain two, single in the first chain space, chain four, single in here, chain two, and your three doubles, 1, 2, and 3. And we're going to do that all the way around, and you should be looking like this. So you should have three chain spaces over there, two chain, three doubles, two single, four single, two, and then your three doubles and two again. So go ahead and do that, and I'll meet you back here. All right, so I've gone all the way around, and I did my chain two, and I'm just slip stitch in the top of this stitch again. And then for this round, we're going to chain three and go in these same ones, 1, 2, 3. Then here you're going to chain two and you're going to do a single, right? So you do your chain two and then you're going to do a single in this middle space, chain two, and then your three doubles at the end. So this is pretty easy. 1, 2, and your third one, and then you're going to do chain two again, and then you're going to just do that all over. So a double in here, double in here, double in here, chain two. So that's your doubles there. One in here, chain two, and then your three doubles at the end. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. This is your easy round again. As I say, now it will be two doubles, one double, sorry, two chain, one double, one double, one double, chain two, single in the middle one, because you've got three in that middle, chain two, and then your doubles here, and chain two. So go ahead and do that round, and I'll meet you back here. All right, so for this ending, you do the same thing, chain two, and just slip stitch into the top of this one. Now you're going to do the same thing, chain three, going to do a double in here so that you have your three doubles, and whoops, then you're going to do your chain two and you're going to do a single in this single, chain two, and one in each of these. So 1, 2, and 3, and then you've got chain two again and start this one, one double, your chain two, single in the single, chain two, one double, and then chain two. And that's what you're going to do all the way around. So it's just your threes with two in between, double, 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 chain two, one single in the single, chain two, and one in each of these. So go ahead and do that and I'll meet you at the beginning again. All right, so come to the end of this one, do your chain two, slip stitch to the top of this one as normal, and chain three. 1, 2, 3. Now this is a real easy one as well. You do your double crochet in there, you double in the next, and then you're not going to do any chains, you're just going to do your double in this one, your double in the next, double in the next, and then, okay, and then you do chain four. So you got your three doubles, chain four, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you're just going to go over here again and do your three doubles, 1, 2, 2, 3. Come straight over all of these, and then you don't do any chains in between. So you're going to skip over all of these and just go into this one here. With 1, 2, and then your third one. And then when you come in between this little set and that set, you do 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And that's what you're going to do for this whole one. So now again, I do these three, just go right over, do those three, and then chain 4. So go ahead and do that, and then I will meet you back once I've finished this round. All right, so once again, we've come all the way around. You've done your chain four, and you're just going to slip stitch into the top of this stitch. Now, for this round, you're going to do your chain three, which stands for your first double crochet. Then these two you're going to do together. So you're going to do that one and this one together. Okay. And then you're going to do the next two together. 1, 2. Do those two together, and then you're going to do one plain double over here. Just like that. Then you're going to do chain five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then you're going to do a single crochet in the middle of this. And you're going to do chain five again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then you're going to do the same thing here. First one is just a double, and then the next two together, that one and that one, the next two together and go in this middle one, one, two together, and then this last one is just a double. Okay, and then you're going to do your chain five, one, two, three, four, five, one single in the middle of this chain, chain five, one, two, three, four, five, and then you're going to do it all over again. So it's one double, two together, one double, chain five, single in the middle of this one. And you're just going to repeat that all the way around. So I'm going to go ahead and do mine, and then I'll meet you back here at the beginning. All right, so we've come around again, and don't forget to do your last single crochet in here. Then you do your chain five, and we're going to just slip stitch into the top of this stitch over here. All right, now what we're going to do, same thing, chain three for your beginning. One, two, three, and we're going to do these three together. So this one, and this one. I'm going to do those three together. Okay, so you've done these three together. You did your first three together, and you're going to chain four. So I've got one, two, three, four, and you're going to slip stitch in here. Sorry, single crochet. Chain four, two, three, four, and slip single crochet in here, and then chain four. One, two, three, four. Now, sorry, after when you did this last row, you should have 16 chain spaces here. So you should have had 16 of these chain spaces on the previous round. Just so you are aware of that. So be sure that you do have your 16, and you can keep going here. Now you've just done your four, and now we're going to do these three together. So you take this one, so not that first one, this one, the middle, and that one. Those are the three you're going to do together. So one, yarn over, two, and this one is three, and then join, go through all of them. So you should be looking like this. Okay, then you do four again. One, two, three, four. Single crochet in that first chain space. One, two, three, four. And single crochet in the next chain space. And then one, two, three, four. And then you start again by doing these three together. All right, so it's a pretty easy round again. As I say, just do your chain fours, single chain four, single chain four, three together. And just repeat that all the way around. So I'm going to go ahead and do mine, and then I will meet you back. Right, so we've come all the way around. Once again, don't forget your last single crochet in here, your chains, and then slip stitch into this top piece over here. Now you should have 24 chain spaces. Okay, so just be sure to have your 24 chain spaces. And sorry, I'm actually going to change my yarn. I'm going to go back to this light color. So however you're doing it, if you're not changing, then just slip stitch with your regular color. But I'm changing mine, and I'm going to use my new color. So go ahead and do that. Make sure that you've got your 24 chain spaces, and we'll continue. All right, so now that you've changed your color, whatever, you're just going to slip stitch into this first chain space. And you're going to do chain one, and then you're going to do chain three for... That first one is standing for your single crochet, and then you're going to do one, two, three. So you're inevitably you're doing chain four. Then you're going to do a single crochet in here. You do your chain three, and you're going to do a single crochet in the next chain space. And then chain three. So you did your chain three, and then you're just going to do a single crochet in this chain here. And that's all that you're going to do. So for this round, just do chain three and a single crochet in the middle of your chains that you had made. So I'm going to go ahead and do that, and then I'll meet you back here. So when you've come all the way around, you're going to just do your chains and then come into this very first stitch with a slip stitch, and you should still have your 24 chain spaces. Okay, then you're going to do chain one, and then you're going to do a single crochet in this very same spot. Okay, and then you're going to do chain five. One, two, three, four, five. And this we did right in the beginning of our hat over here. We're doing the same thing. So chain five, single crochet in this single crochet, chain five, one, two, three, four, five, and a single crochet in your single. And this is all you're going to do. So chain five, one, two, three, four, five, and a single in your single. So go ahead and do that all the way around and I will meet you back at the beginning. All right, so we are getting there. Don't forget your last single crochet there, your chains, five again, and then single slip stitch in here. Once again, you should have 24 of these chain spaces. So we're getting there. We're nearly done with our hat. A few more rows. Now this is going to be the same as what we did in the beginning. So you did your slip stitch in here, and then you're going to do chain four. So 1, 2, 3, 4. That stands for a double crochet and a chain one. Then you're going to do a double in the same place. Okay, then you're going to do a single crochet in the middle of this chain five. And then you're going to do a double, chain one, and a double in the same place. You might remember this from right in the beginning, but that's all that you're going to do. So single in here, and then in this spot here where you did your single crochet, you do a double, chain one, and a double. And then you're going to do a single in the middle of this chain. And that's pretty easy. You might remember it from what you did right in the beginning here. So yeah, that's basically it. One double in the single crochet, one chain, one double in that same single crochet, and then a single crochet in the middle of this chain. And that's it. So I'm going to go ahead and do that all the way around, and then I will meet you back here. All right, so we've done that, and then you do your last single crochet in here. And then you're just coming into the top of this stitch here. Just do a slip stitch over there. Okay, then you're going to do one chain and one single crochet in the same space. Okay, then you're going to do chain five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you're going to do a single crochet over here where you had done the double crochet chain one. Okay, and then chain five, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a single crochet right in between the doubles where you had done that one chain. And that's all you're going to do. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a single in between the two doubles over here. So go ahead and do that, and I'll meet you back here. All right, so we came to the end again. You're going to slip stitch into the beginning of this one, and then we're going to do our chain three, one, two, three, and then one chain four in between. So it's a double with a chain, and then you're going to do a double crochet in the same place. So this is the same as the previous row, and then a single crochet in here. So it's a double, one chain, and a double, and then it's a single in the middle of this one. Okay, and that's what you're going to do the whole way. One double, one chain, one double in the same, and a single crochet in the middle of this one. So it's exactly the same as you did down here. These two rows are just repeated. So go ahead and do that, and then I'll meet you back here. All right, so once you've done your last ones, don't forget your last single crochet in there, then you're just going to come to the top of this with a slip stitch. Now, if you want yours to be longer, you can go ahead and do another set of these where you just do your chain five, single crochet, chain five, and then come back with this. So you can repeat this again. We did it twice. So if you want yours longer, you can. Otherwise, if you want to end off, now there's no set law on what I'm going to show you here. We're going to do the reverse single crochet. So you're going to chain one. Now you don't want to do too many of these, but you don't want to do too few. So you go backwards. So you're literally doing a single crochet backwards. So you go from there, just go into this one and do a single crochet. So you're literally going backwards. Okay, so I'm going to go in there and do a single. I'm going to come in this one, do a single. So that's why I'm saying that I can't tell you exactly which stitch. It's really the next stitch, but if you find yours is getting a bit too wide or it's getting too many, spread them out a bit more. Basically, I'm going into each stitch. And it just gives you a firm little border here. So you're going to have to just monitor yours. As I say, if you find that yours is getting to be too wide, skip a stitch. If you find it's too tight, you can do two in one. But really, I'm just going backwards, one into each stitch. And you don't actually even have to do this if you don't want to. It works. It's fine as it is. It's a very firm hold there. But I just like to end mine off. So, yeah, that's basically all that I'm going to be doing. And, yeah, that's your hat. So, yeah, as I say, if you want to make this longer, go ahead and do another set of those. Otherwise, your hat is complete. So thank you so much for joining me in this video, and I hope that your hat has come out well. If you need any help, feel free to ask me and I'll help you as best as I can. And I do have a Facebook page if you want to join. I have a Pinterest, and all the info is down below. I have a blog where 90% of the patterns have been written out, and you can find me there.
See you in my next video. Thanks so much. Bye.